step. Okay, measurement of internal resistance using D-arsenide galvanometer. Okay, a typical D-arsenide galvanometer will be in this manner. You have the IM range of galvanometer that is present on the scale. You have the positive, you have the negative, and you have a screw type setup over here. Okay, you can see the screw over here. Okay, first, before measuring the internal resistance, make sure that no power supply is connected to your galvanometer. When no power supply is given to your galvanometer, the pointer should point to 0 microamps. If it is not showing 0 microamps, with the help of a screwdriver, adjust the pointer to 0 microamps in the galvanometer. Okay, now coming to the first part, measurement of internal resistance. For the measurement of internal resistance, you need a regulator power supply, you need two DRBs and the galvanometer. First, the positive of the galvanometer power supply is given to the decay resistance box. From the decay resistance box, we are giving it to the galvanometer positive, and from the galvanometer negative, we are connecting it to the power supply negative. All the resistances in the decay resistance box are kept in the maximum position. This is to protect. When the resistance over here is low, the large amount of current passes through the galvanometer, which might damage it. So in order to protect the galvanometer, you are keeping the resistance in the DRB in the maximum position. Then switch on your power supply. Keep a voltage greater than 2 volts in your power supply. Then by adjusting the resistors in the DRB, make sure that you are getting full scale reflection in your galvanometer. Okay, now we are approximately getting full scale reflection in the galvanometer. Full scale deflection in the galvanometer. Now take another DRB, keep all the knobs in the minimum position. All the knobs in the minimum position, and connect this galvanometer and connect this DRB in parallel to your galvanometer. When you connect this DRB in parallel with your galvanometer,
Pass
this again.